Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Swing Around the World Network. Hear music, dance, short lessons and much more to connect people together and to show everyone power of swing. Today, Bordeaux Swing. Sure Tail Stompers. Alexey Kazennov. Elena Evangelia. Pamela Gaizutyte. Stormy Weather. Leonor Piñar. And Gas Fernandez.
Hello, hello, I'm Alexey Kazennov, and welcome back. So today I prepared a new colorized video for you, and this time we're moving from 20s and 30s to 50s. And I prepared a clip from film Don't Knock the Rock from 1956 with music by Bill Haley and his Comets. It's Rip It Up. And there you will see a lot of dancers, you will see a full dance floor, you will see some one spots, you even will see a jump circle, so like really rich video with the dancing, I will say. It took me a lot of time to prepare because of small details there, and I really hope you will enjoy it. So yes, let's start!
Sedative.
But you must admit it's just dancing, that's all. These kids aren't doing anything wrong.
Well, darling, how can I tell? They all move so fast, it looks like a double exposure.
You promised you'd report only...
Hey! Hello, everyone. I'm Elena Evangelia, I come from Athens, Greece. And tonight we're dancing a few moves of the most entertaining dance, the black bottom. The origins of the black bottom are dated back in the first decade of the 20th century in New Orleans. It is a wild African-American vernacular jazz dance, and it almost replaced Charleston back in the 20s. It uses a lot of knee twists, a lot of torso and pelvic movement, and rhythm stops and shuffling. What do you say? Let's try it out. So, black bottom movement number one. your knees together, bend them with your pelvis back, and we'll try to do two counts with our pelvis back, two counts forward and up on my toes, and two counts back again, and stay for another two. I knee slap on one, two, and I can snap with the left arm, or I can just go boom, very fabulous, a boom, and then forward, and my arms are back with a circling motion, boom. And then the other way, shoop, I push out on my toes, but we back. And the last part, going for my hairstyle, facing. My pelvis is going back and forward and back and stay, stay. My bounce is there. And knee slap, back, push, here. 5, 6, 7, and go. Shoop. One more time. 5, 6, 7. Push. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Amazing. Black bottom move number 2. I'm gonna be facing you backwards. If that makes sense. Let's try it together. Do a follow the load. Two, ba ba dee ya, boo ba ba dee ya, ba do shari, ba do shari. Yes. Now I'm going to place a black bottom twist variation to this amazing follow the load. Try to bend your knees and keep the twisting action going. I'm going for in and out. Try together, guys. In. In, out. I'm also thinking of my knees instead of my heels, so that I can have this triangle here when I'm twisting. Twisting in and out, in and out, in and out. Bravo. Okay, let's try it together. I'm going to do an inside twist, and then when I cross behind, my knees are out. To the side is in, cross forward, out again. And in, tuck, side, forward, in, tuck, and in, shoot, cross, and in. Let's try it again. I'm going to be your mirror, starting with your right foot. Out. 5, 6, 7. In. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Think about your knees and try to keep the bouncing action. And your feet will be able to twist a lot easier on the floor. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now your arms can be here. 5, 6, 7. And you keep down, check, you keep down. Yes. Black bottom move number 3. Let's try some knee slapping. Shoot, 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 shoot. Yes. Now let's try to make it a little bit more upwards. Mm-hmm. A little bit, my pelvis a little bit backwards. My chest is out. And I'm doing the knee slap with both of my palms. Shoot, shoot. I'm going to do a double one. Double knee slap. Yes. I step and I rotate myself. To one slice of the pizza to the left, to the right. Shoot, and again to the left. Shoot, right knee is facing to the left, 45 degrees. Left knee is facing to the right, 45 degrees. Yes. And shoot, shoot, and bounce, 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 bounce. 5, 6, 7, go. Ha, 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 ha. Instead of a knee slap, more of a knee slap. Yes, I'm pulling up from my thighs. Oh, I'm pulling up my feet. Try it with me again, using your right foot. 5, 6, 7. And 1, 3, 5, 7. 2, 3, 5, 7. It's a lot of a count accent. Left bottom movement number has a knee twist, it has arms are falling out like raindrops. It is called raindrops. Yes, with your arms up, then on your shoulders, then down. They're falling right like rain on your body. Shubiriya, shubiriya, shubiriya. Try to imagine that you only have joints. 5, 6, 7, shubiriya, shubiriya. No muscles, no nothing in between. Check out what my knees are doing again. I'm going for an inside twist, out, and then inside again. Let's try. So, my arms are up, my knees are twisted in, out, in. Okay, let's put all those four moves into a small combo. We're starting with the posing. Shubiriya, go and twice. Shubiriya, and 1, 2, 3, pull along. And 3, 5, 6, 7, 7. Knee slaps. Knee slaps. And rain drops in, out, down. Let's try together and counting. 5, 6, 7, go.
1926. Oh my God, I'm out of breath.
Thank you all for taking this class tonight. I hope to see you soon in person. Hugs and kisses from Athens, Greece.
excites me. Hot rhythm stimulates me. Can't help but swing it, boy. Swing it, brother, swing. Don't stop to diddle-daddle. Stop this foolish prattle. Come on and swing it, boy. Swing it, brother, swing. Raring to go. And there ain't nobody gonna hold me down. Say you listen, boy. Hurry up and send me, let me go to town. Stop this diddle-daddle. Foolish brattle, come on and swing it, boy. Swing it, brattle, swing. Dop today, die. Dop today, die. Dop today, die. Dop today, die. Swing it, brattle, swing. Dop today, die. Dop today, die. Dop today, die. Dop today, die. Swing it, brattle, swing. This diddle daddle and this foolish prattle. Come on and swing it, boy. Swing it, brattle, swing. Swing it, brattle, swing. Swing. Brother. Swing, brattle, swing.
You brothers and sisters, and we need to go back on stage and play some solid swing for you all. In the meantime, go online and find our brand new CD, Savoy Heyday, from the Billy Brothers Swing Orchestra, the best black orchestras of the 30s and the 40s. Savoy Heyday.
Thank you. morning, good afternoon, and good evening. Welcome to Swing Around the World. I am Delphine Dalagata, and today I am with Pamela Gaizutyte, a swing dancer, teacher, and entrepreneur from Lithuania. Thank you for joining us, Pamela.
Thanks for having me.
It's a pleasure. So you've been dancing since you were 5 years old, and you have continued to make it your career. What has inspired and motivated you to continue?
Well, it sounds very bombastic. It started since 5 years old, but my first dance steps was when I was five, and then I danced folk dancing till I was 16. And I didn't really like dancing. It was not like, oh, I like dancing, I'm gonna be a dancer. I did it because my mom made me to. And then I switched schools and I stopped dancing, and I was like, oh, finally I can do something else. But after half a year with no dancing, I really missed the movement, and Lindy Hop entered into my life. And that's when the whole perspective and story changed. So when I danced Lindy Hop for 1 year, I was like, ooh, I really miss performing, you know, because before I hated it. And now I was like, I want to share dancing. I want to show how much I enjoy this. And then in different years, different things happened that kept me in dancing, because there were moments where I wanted to quit the professional life and just stay dancing socially. But yeah, different things, like people kept me, the notion of learning and knowing about this dance kept me there, and then the feeling of that I can express myself more and more kept me there too. So different things in different years worked.
Really incredible. And it has taken you around the globe from what I've seen and of your career. It's been probably very fulfilling to be able to share it with such a wide audience also, and not only in your country, but elsewhere in the world. So really inspiring to hear that even if you are forced at the beginning, you can develop a passion for it and make it a worthwhile commitment. So on the side of dancing, you have also created your own shoe line called P.Mela Swingin' Shoes brand. So could you share a bit more about the process that you go behind creating the collections, the materials you use, the inspiration you have?
Yeah, so it started, you know, in a funny way. A friend had shoes, I like them, da 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 da, and then formed a group of friends who started doing it, because at that time when we started it, it was not so much dance shoes dedicated for dancing, except ballroom shoes, you know. And I loved high heels, but it was just too painful to teach in high heels and practice in high heels all the time, at least for me. So that's how it started. And then it was just fun to get into it. But I also thought that, like, I don't want to be seen like a shoe seller, because I'm mainly dancer, but I kind of want to work with my friends and have projects. My personality likes projects. So I thought that them making shoes and having projects and collections could be a great way to spread some kind of messages. So each collection is used to say something about the dance, about the dancers, music, partnership, things I go through. Because for every collection I'm writing the text. I have a Lena associate of mine, so she takes care of the web pages, answers the messages, you know, she does all the work, and I'm doing all the creative work, choosing materials and dedicating collections to certain things, writing text, and it's all usually about what I'm going through in my dance life. So if I feel like partnership is something that I'm figuring out and is something important to me, I usually dedicate a collection for that. If I'm digging more into music and music history and things like that, I dedicate collection to that. And yeah, so it's more of a platform for me to be creative in different ways rather than just dancing.
Super cool. Could you share what the current collection is inspired by?
So current collection is called Skillful, and this time we have not only shoes, but we have clothing line as well. And it's jumpsuits because they're super comfy to practice in. And somehow all the lines so far been about practicing and dancing and working, because I don't really connect it to the performing yet. But in our plans, there's some, you know, maybe high heels, maybe dresses, maybe women's suits and things like that. We'll see what's gonna happen. So yeah, this collection is dedicated to skills, because for a past year I've been thinking a lot about classes and dancing, and when I teach dance I'm trying to explain how I think about the dance and how I go about it. And I've been telling more and more that dancing for me is combination of skills. I have skill of turning, and I have skill of keeping the beat, and I have skill of showing the structure of the music, and then I have a skill of grooving in different ways, and I have these different sets of skills that I practice this skill, practice that skill, do a little bit of this, and then in the end it kind of comes closer and closer together. And that's why in the end we call it Skillful.
Yeah, beautiful. And I think that's a very poetic way of also explaining the process behind becoming a dancer. And you see usually the beautiful, finished, polished product of a performance, but behind it is all this work, this puzzle piece after coming, you know, one after the other, and culminating in this final performance. But all the hard work, all the, you know, the mechanics behind it also is complex, and it's great to reflect that also in a different medium. And so obviously you haven't stopped creating or moving during this time, because obviously it's been a challenging past year, and it's going to continue being challenging for artists and musicians worldwide. And I know you have been able to stay connected with your, because you are a teacher, and with your students, and you developed what's called an awareness through the jazz kind of live stream. Could you tell us a bit more on what you share on that platform and how you continue building the community even if you are at a distance?
Yes. So Awareness Through the Jazz was a workshop of mine that I used to do in Vilnius. And I think I did it a few times or something around that. And when we went into lockdown, or into second lockdown, or was like, you know, I couldn't travel for more than half a year, I was like, okay, it's time to maybe connect with some dancers and dedicate at least 1 hour and a half per week to, you know, definitely make sure that I dance. Because the way I look in the way I look at dance, or even at life, if I want to do something, sometimes I don't find motivation, like working out or eating really well all the time, or even dancing. I struggle with that too. I struggle with having motivation or creating or whatever. So what I do, I set life in that way that I have to do it. So it's like, okay, if I gather the group, then I have to do it. And then it's like, if, you know, I have to commit. So that's how it started. And then it's just Awareness Through the Jazz is another thing that I talk a lot in the dance. I talk about building awareness. It's the same thing about set of skills. It's just understanding, what am I doing? So I always say it's not a mistake if you know what you're doing. So if you're doing this and you're like, no, I'm standing still, I'm like, are you standing still? You know, but if you know that you're shrugging your shoulders, or if you know that you're standing like this and that's your goal to have this kind of style, you have enough of awareness, then it's not a mistake. So, and this name, Awareness Through the Jazz, was already, you know, kind of known for some dancers, so it was easier just to use the same name. So that's how it started. And I thought I'm gonna do it for a month. I had like lecture types of classes where I was more talking than dancing and sharing my knowledge. But then I felt like, it was fun. Let's do another month where we practice all the things of what I shared. And then that was so much fun, and people wanted to continue. And now we will have the fifth month of Awareness Through the Jazz, and people are welcome to join. These classes are based on improvisation, because improvisation is a big value of mine. I feel more comfortable improvising than doing a performance or a showcase. Like if I have to improvise while I'm performing, I'm like, okay. But you know, because I'm more afraid to forget choreography and mess up steps and things like that. So this class is based on that, and we do a lot of exercises, and we share and we talk and we play games, and of course I give steps and some routines, but then we take a point, we take time to see how I can improvise with that. Because in the end, it's improvisational rhythmical dance. So how can I learn something and take it there? So that's what it's focused on.
No, really interesting. And it's true that so many of us had our routines kind of uprooted and had to recreate this new modality, new way of doing our own work. And I think one thing on being mindful and self-aware in a time of isolation where you're spending maybe a lot of time introverting and in your own body, being able to have these moments, weekly encounters, monthly encounters, where you're able to focus on what is changing, what is happening in your body, is really unique. And I'm assuming that you were able to reach a much larger audience, since normally you were doing it, you know, in your hometown, or at least where you were living at that moment. And now you've been able to engage with a wider audience. Do you think that will change how it will develop in the future, maybe? Or would you keep it in this online format, or you would aim to have it back in person?
There's a few things. So one thing that it's funny, I'm not so known in Lithuania, where I am from and where I'm living, because I've been traveling so much. So it's not that Lithuanian swing scene is so interested in that. I mean, I'm surprised, because like Lithuanian dancers, I think they're just waiting for warmer weather and social dancing and then go dancing. They're not so much engaged into classes, as much as I know. So yeah, but it's of course rewarding to be able to reach so many people around me from different countries. But you know, this is still like online class, so different time zones, but people take class recordings and I try to keep in touch with them through messages if they have questions or something like that. You know, it's difficult, it's challenging, it's completely different way of living. And you know, before that we used to go to places because we were hired and we didn't have to do the whole promotion work and, you know, and inviting people like so much as we do now. So that's something new and challenging and quite stressful, I would say, if I'm honest. But it teaches different things as well, so there's that. So I don't know how long I want to continue doing that, you know. I'm like, it's fun, but it's also a lot of work and different kind of work. So that class that I do once a week, which is 1.5 hours, it's so much more work before and after. So it's fun, it's nice, but I'm actually not sure how it's gonna continue, how it's gonna go, where we're gonna go. At this point, I'm trying not to think about that, because it, depending on the day and then on the mood, you know, sometimes it feels hopeful and optimistic, and sometimes I'm like, I'm so done with this. I just wanna see live people, you know. And so what I'm trying to say, there's so many different perspective about this, it's hard for me to answer your question.
No, it's normal. I think everyone's taking everything day by day, and we're figuring out solutions and ways to keep our moods up as the rest of the world seems to always be collapsing down around you. So it's definitely inspiring to know that you are contributing what you can to the community you've created, and continue to let that grow. If people that are watching right now would like to stay in touch and discover more on what you're doing, what's the best way they can get updated? Is there social media platforms? What's the best?
I think I'm mostly active on Instagram, so they can find me there by my name and surname. And there's a newsletter that I send every month on what's happening in online world and what classes I'm doing. In April, it's a lot of new things. I've been practicing with Tadas, my friend in Lithuania, so we're gonna have a Lindy Hop class, online Lindy Hop class. It's gonna be my first. So we're gonna have that in April, and many more things. And if someone wants to join, you're very welcome.
Super. I am curious to know more about what you're going to get up to. So I'll consider signing up. Super.
Did you
Thank
do
you
any...
so much for sharing.
You're welcome. That's okay. I just wanted to ask if you, did you yourself try some online classes? Did you enjoy them?
I did. In the first lockdown last spring, there were live lessons on, I think it was on Instagram, and I would follow them usually on a weekly basis. To be honest, though, when we hit the second wave in the fall, I was so tired of screens. I was spending at work, I was spending all day in Zoom calls, and then I was home. I was like, I don't want another Zoom call. So I've been taking a bit of a break from online dance lessons, and hopefully my love and passion for dance will be reborn once we're able to meet in person.
Oh, I'm sure.
But right now, I think the Zoom, it's the Zoom fatigue. It's just not, for a social dance, it's so tough to find that same
Zoom
energy
fatigue.
When you're not in the same room.
That's a good
It's a real term.
It's a real term? Wow, I never heard it. Zoom fatigue. I understand that. It's hard to make yourself do it, especially because it's so much screen time. But like afterwards, it's rewarding. But to make yourself do it, like every Monday, I'm like, oh my God. And then when you do it, you know, all the adrenaline hormones and everything kicks in and you're like, yay.
Yeah, maybe if I did it like outside, if I changed the location so I wasn't always inside, maybe that would change. Now that the days are getting longer and there's more sunlight, maybe that could be a way to boost the motivation and desire to get out there moving.
We'll see.
But yeah. I still love watching performances and, you know, supporting artists. It's just not through a dance class right now.
Yeah, I understand.
But thank you again for letting me ask you a few questions about your life and your career. It
Thanks.
Was a pleasure to meet you, even if it was just virtually.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, looking forward to hopefully connecting maybe on a real dance floor someday.
I hope so, yeah.
Right. Okay, well, thank you so much, Pamela.
Thanks, love.
Something.
You ain't seen nothing yet. Talk about a tree. You should see that chick and me strutting down the street. My, my, ain't that something? Jimmy shout. Mm-mm, ain't that something? Ain't that something to shout about?
everyone. I'm Leonor Piñar, and this is the last class of the Charleston 20s routine. Today we will learn the last phrase, and we will put everything together. The fourth phrase is a bit special. It lasts 4/8, and it starts with snake hips. It's a really beautiful movement, really used in the 20s by some great dancers like Earl Tucker, Ann Pennington, or Josephine Baker. Let's try it. Snake hips. This movement comes from the hips. You can practice this in front of a mirror. Soften your knees, and you have to draw with your hips an 8. So, move your hip to one side, up, back to the center, the other side, back, up, and back to the center. You can also lift one foot, drag it, lift and drag. Put your hands on your hips. It will help you to block everything but the hips. Let's try just this. Start lifting your right foot. Lift and back, lift and back. Hips, move your hips. One side and the other. Cool. So when you got this, you can practice to go down and up. Soften your knees and pay attention to your joints. Open a bit your feet and start going down and up and down and up. Nice. We will do this movement, snake hips, 4/8. Let's try 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Nice. Next, we're going to use hip push. It's similar to the fish tail. So, you have to move your hip to the side and back and straight one leg. Try to the other side, push, 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 push. Nice. We're going to play with the tempo and make 3 hip pushes on 1, on 5, and on 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. And we will be turning and we will finish facing that way. Okay, let's try 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Cool. From this position, we will make the break, the last step of our routine. It's a break that was really used by Josephine Baker and combines the knees and the arms. Okay, so you will have to bend one knee and straight the other one 4 times, like this. Okay, and in the same time, you will have to move and lift the opposite arm, like this, and open and close your chest. Let's try. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we finish like this. Okay, let's try just this phrase from the top with counts and then to the music. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, set. And that's all. Now it's time to put everything together. Let's remember from the top, first with count. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 5, and repeat. 1, 2, 3, 5, basic. 3, 4, 5, another. 1, 2, 3, to the side. 1, 2, slide. And the cartwheel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Second phrase. Basic. 1, 2, 4, 5. Black bottom. 1, 2, 3, 5. Another basic. 1, 2, 3. Cartwheel. 2 and 2. From here. Follow the left. And cross behind. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Third phrase. Happy feet. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 1, 4, 5, 7. 2, 3, 4, 5. And flying feet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. And the 4, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. 1, 3, 4, 5, 7. And the break. 3, 4, 5, 7. Great! Let's try the last time. Dance with me to the music. I hope you had fun. Take care, keep dancing, and hopefully we will meet very soon on the dance floor. Bye!
Jungle. Jungle Jive. This vinyl from a Swedish collector, that's a man anyway. But this vinyl is dedicated to jungle music. The jungle music is a style of jazz that some people say that was you can even the creator of that style. And it's a style that particularly from the 20, 26, 27 ahead, mainly was played in the Cotton Club. The reason why they create this style was just, you know, like commercial things. Like they try to do something different, and then they to attract people. So like, oh, this is where they play the jungle style. You will listen in the song that they use a lot of mutes on the trombones and trumpets, and the drum set is a little different. Try to create this feeling of being jungle. But anyway. It doesn't matter if it was like a commercial thing, because it's great, I love it. And it's one of this style as well that when we dance sometimes we feel a little bit uncomfortable to dance with, because we don't understand really well, or we feel like something is weird. But well, doesn't matter, again, just fight with that. If you find a band playing this, just go and do it. More if it's live music. This is not something easy to interpret. Well, I hope you enjoy the jungle style. The song that we will listen to is Jungle Night in Harlem by Duke Ellington Orchestra.
Thank you.